opening up your email.
Okay. How's everything going?
I help Joey keep on track with his financial plan via the internet, conference calls, and the computer.
I had the client summary. And
living on different parts of the country, that's how we communicated.
Anthony and I grew up in Norwalk, Connecticut.
And we sort of grew up together. And then, he went his way, I went my way.
And I came back to Connecticut working as a pastor at a local church. And Anthony had begun his career at Northwestern and approached me.
I showed him a scenario that would play out for him if he got married and had children. I didn't know he was going to have 5 children.
The timing was right. I felt like I wanted to make some decisions about planning for the future.
The planning was in stages. The first part was insured savings, and then it turned into being married and purchasing insurance. Then it turned into him purchasing insurance for children. Then it actually turned into Wendy purchasing insurance for the family as well.
My wife was working as a nurse, and I was making a modest income as a pastor, and so Anthony was working with me to take these small steps initially to care for Wendy and now my family. Wendy was beautiful, smart, compassionate. At best, she was a mom and a wife, and healthy as a horse. So when she became ill 4 years ago, we were all very surprised and dumbfounded that she had stage 4 ovarian cancer with no family history, no exposure. And she was courageous and brave and helped to really walk the children through it as well. And really never complained. She was, an amazing woman.
Wendy was a special lady. Beautiful, nice, heart of gold. She was a special lady. She really was.
Well, 20 years ago, the objective was, what if something were to happen to me? And then when Wendy stopped working and our family grew, we had to address the question, okay, what if something happened to Wendy? And now I'm a single dad with young children. And so today I find myself as a single dad. So we're at a different stage, but the plan was basically not having to work for a season to recover, to heal, to grieve, to regroup as a family. So I'm able to do that.
Well, he's able to make choices now. First, be a dad to his kids, be there for them. I just think that's a big deal. And I think it was important for Wendy to know that they're gonna be okay.
The financial stability we have now, not having to work for a season, getting my head on straight and exploring what options has taken the stress off. I've told the kids, well, let's do some fun things while we can. And it's bittersweet because I would have loved to have been able to do these things with Wendy. And so now we can do them without her, but in her memory, so.